Welcome back to Footballology. So today I want to talk to you guys about Bill O'Brien and the trade that he made for D-Hop, or not for D-Hop, but for David Johnson, and trading D-Hop to the Arizona Cardinals. Now, when this trade first went down, I knew David Johnson was going to get traded. I foresaw that a long time ago. I put a video out about it and everything. But to the Texans, I didn't see that happening, or even the Texans and the Cardinals dealing anything at all. And especially DeAndre Hopkins being one of those guys coming from the Texans. This trade in my mind, I just didn't see happening. And I mean, David Johnson for sure, D-Hop, no way possible. So before we really start to dig deep into this video, I just want the Houston Texans fans out there to understand that I'm not defending Bill O'Brien or anything of that nature. But I'm really starting to understand where he's coming from. I guess you could say, like, I'm not agreeing with what he did, but I'm just, I guess, having that moment of truth. Like, okay, I understand, you know, but it's your ship. You're the captain. And so when Bill O'Brien pretty much took over the reins of the Houston Texans as general manager, he became that player personnel guy, the guy that really started to pull the trigger on players, on guys that he wanted on the roster. So then he had an ability to really kind of do whatever he wants. And I think the owner at this point pretty much gave Bill O'Brien the free range and said, hey, do what you think is going to help this team win. And Bill O'Brien said, okay. Now I know there was a lot of heat between D-Hop and in the organization as well in a couple of instances, but I didn't think he was a superstar caliber receiver, top five in the league easily. And I just didn't see it happening, just like everyone else. But when you really start to dig down and really start to pay attention to what happened, once Bill O'Brien got the keys to the franchise, he understood that he probably had maybe one, possibly 2 years, depending on how this year turns out. But he knew he had for sure 1 year to say, I'm going to have this, the keys to the franchise, and I got to do what's right. What I think is going to give me and this team to have the best chance to have success and really take our game to the next level. And trading away D-Hop, he felt like it was a good move because he needed a running back. We all understood that they needed a running back. The running back situation was kind of shaky. They just kind of start to retool their offensive line. As you can see in midseason, he was really starting to pull the trigger on that position as well and really bringing in players there. And so once he started to kind of move pieces around and really start to get his guys in place, you could start to see the team take on a whole new identity. And I think what he had envisioned for this roster and for this team going into the 2021 season was, or I guess 2020-2021 season, was without DeAndre Hopkins. He didn't see D-Hop being a part of this team. It's kind of almost interesting because it looked like the way their wide receiver core is set up, and with David Johnson definitely could run between the tackles. We understand that. But with the wide receiving core, it seems like it's going to be a high-flying wide receiver core. Like, guys are just going to be running nothing but post and deep post and corners and goes and fades. Like, they're just going to be taking the top off defenses consistently with Will Fuller and Brandon Cooks. And then, you know, pretty much working underneath with the guys like David Johnson or Darren Fells, I think they're tight end as well. So, like, they're just, you know, they got a little bit of something going on there. I'm not sure what it is exactly, but it's kind of interesting to see where this offense is going. And so Bill O'Brien just went out and he traded away, you know, top three, top five receiver. He got a running back that everybody knows that when he's healthy, and that's the asterisk mark of this Houston Texans offense. When they're healthy, they probably could be dangerous, but it's always that when they are healthy. But we know for a fact when David Johnson's healthy, he could be easily a top five running back in the league. You know, definitely through the air and on the ground. He's just what he does, and that's what he's done since he's gotten into the league. But if he can stay on the field, it makes the trade look even more interesting. Now, like I said, I'm not defending Bill O'Brien. I'm not agreeing with what he did. I completely 100% disagree with what he did, but I'm understanding what he did. If you're going to be the chef, like, and I always talk about this, and we always talk about team building and really putting together your roster. If you're going to be the chef in the kitchen cooking the meals, you're not going to send your assistant out to the market to go get vegetables and fish and chicken or whatever the case may be, to go get all the ingredients that you need to create this masterpiece of a recipe, because you have a food critic coming in, right? So when you have a food critic coming in, you want the best dish possible, and you make sure you got the best ingredients possible. And if you know, if you're cooking for a high profile guy or a food critic of that level, you're gonna make sure that dish is perfect, right? And so think of Bill O'Brien as being the chef. and he's gonna go. He's not gonna send out an assistant or this guy or anybody. He's gonna go out and he's gonna go to the market himself, and he's gonna pick out all the fresh ingredients. He's gonna get what he needs to make sure that this meal is the best meal he could possibly put out. So trading away DeAndre Hopkins basically gave him that opportunity to make sure that no matter what he put out this year, he know that he picked the ingredients, that he put together this meal, or he went out to the market and picked up all the ingredients to make sure this meal was prepared the way it should be. And now if that meal turns into an 11-5 season, then so be it. If it turns into a 5-11 season, so be it. But he understands that he's going to crash and burn with this meal, regardless of what it is. Or, you know, if he's the captain, he's going to crash and burn with this ship. But he understands that he did whatever was right for him to have the best coaching situation, and for the team and organization to give him the best opportunity to put this team in, you know, winning positions, if you will, from game in and game out. I'm not justifying the trade, but it just wasn't in the, you know, in the books for him to have DeAndre Hopkins. You know, maybe he's seen something, a better offense with David Johnson. Maybe he felt that having a running back like David Johnson could take off the load off his young quarterback and really kind of make the run game more balanced. And Bill O'Brien comes from the New England Patriots, when we've seen, you know, Bill Belichick be the guy that, you know, goes out and he goes to the market every day and every year and picks his ingredients and still puts out a quality product every year. And so Bill O'Brien actually has to understand, and I'm pretty sure, I wouldn't be surprised, I'm not, you know, 100% positive about this, but I'm pretty sure he probably reached out to Bill and said, hey, you know, what do I do, what do you do, and how do you go about handling the GM side of things and the coaching side of things and really not being so stressed out on both sides. I mean, he's wearing two hats, but I'm pretty sure he's reached out to him. We've seen Andy Reid do it in Philadelphia. Andy Reid had a really good long tenure there in Philly, and I mean, he had some success. I mean, it was up and down, but he had some good success there. But he was also wearing two hats when he was in Philly. So this is just going to give Bill O'Brien, like I said, the best opportunity to put out the best product possible. I don't want to say he's on the hot seat just yet, but I think he's realistically on the hot seat. Like, he has a one shot at this. And I know that if you sat down with the owner and he said, hey, here it is, do what you think is best for the roster. You know, don't ask me, don't ask anybody else, what you think is best, what you think is going to give you the best chance to win ball games every Sunday. I think he said, okay, I believe trading away DeAndre Hopkins is going to do that plus some. And I mean, they got a little bit of draft capital back, but obviously not for what D-Hop was worth, but they got a little bit of draft capital back. So it's going to be interesting, like I said, what this offense can be and what it could turn into if they're healthy. I think they could still be a quality offense. It just sucks not seeing D-Hop dressed in the Texans uniform. And he's worked hard at it, but Bill O'Brien knows something we don't, and he understands something we don't. He might just have a whole new offense and scheme drawn up now for these guys that he has on the field. So it's going to be interesting. I really think it's going to be interesting. I'm really excited to see what this offense is going to look like, mainly because I feel like David Johnson is going to be the feature guy, and I'm a huge David Johnson guy. So I think it's going to be cool. I think it's going to be really interesting how Bill O'Brien is going to go about this. So let me know what you guys think. Do you feel like, obviously, I'm not going to say, do you guys feel like the trade was bad? Because everybody feel like the trade was bad. But do you at least understand where Bill O'Brien was coming from? And if you're in Bill O'Brien's situation where you're wearing two hats, would you make an offense more surrounded around D-Hop and try to find other pieces to fill in the voids? Or would you ship out D-Hop and try to fill those voids that way? Let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. If Bill O'Brien's good, if he's bad, do you think the Texans are actually going to do better this year or worse this year by losing D-Hop? Just let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. I'm always in the comment section. The conversation is good, and I appreciate quality conversation. Also, if you guys are not a footballologist yet, I don't know what you're waiting on. Go and subscribe to the YouTube channel today, become a footballologist, and stay safe, football fans.